pom, story time with Dad. This is my favorite story time. Under the bed in my secret fort, and I'm gonna read. Harold and the Purple Crayon. One evening, after thinking it over, for some reason, Harold decided to go for a walk in the moonlight. That's so cool. When I'm sleeping, I want to do adventures too. There wasn't any moon, and Harold needed a moon for a walk in the moonlight. Oh, how come there wasn't a moon? Well, that night was dark, and we need something to walk on, like stairs? Sure. Or a path or a sidewalk. He made a long straight path so he wouldn't get lost. He's so smart. What color did he draw in? I think red. I think purple. He set off on his walk, taking his big purple crayon with him. That's so cool. But he didn't seem to be getting anywhere on the long straight path. Where was he going? An adventure? Yeah. So he left the path for a shortcut across the field, and the moon went with him. Hello, Harold. I'm gonna tag along with you. Okay. The shortcut led right to where Harold thought a forest ought to be. A forest? Really cool. Boop, boop, boop. He didn't want to get lost in the woods, so he made a very small forest with just one tree in it. That's a really small forest. One tree.
Would be very tasty, Harold thought, when they got red.
So is he going to call them red?
So he put a frightening dragon under the tree to guard the apples. It was a terribly frightening dragon. It even frightened Harold. He backed away.
You're so frightening.
His hand holding the purple crayon shook.
Oh no!
Suddenly he realized what was happening.
What was happening? Tell us. Oh no!
But by then Harold was over his head in an ocean.
An ocean?
Blub, 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 blub. He came up thinking fast.
What did he think of? A boat? A ship? A float?
And in no time, he was climbing aboard a trim little boat. He's so smart. Yeah. So now he's riding on the sea. And he quickly set sail. He drew a sail. That's so clever. And the moon sailed along with him. Hi, Harold. I'm here for you. After it sailed long enough, Harold made land without much trouble.
Oh, he got to land. Oh, wow. Cool.
He stepped ashore on the beach, wondering where he was.
Where was he? Where am I?
I'm on a nice beach. The sandy beach reminded Harold of picnics.
And he thought of picnics made him hungry. I'm hungry too. I want peanut butter and jelly. I want egg salad. I want tuna salad.
So he laid out a nice, simple picnic lunch. He made a blanket and some plates, but he only drew pie. There was nothing but pie. Cherry pie? Or apple pie? Or pumpkin pie? Or blueberry pie? What kind of pie? Harold finished his picnic. There was quite a lot of left of pies.
He must have been full. He ate so much pie.
He hated to see so much delicious pie go to waste.
Yeah, I wish I was there to have some pie.
So Harold left a very hungry moose and a deserving porcupine to finish up all the pies. They were so happy. And off he went looking for a hill to climb to see where he was.
Ooh, he's gonna draw a hill?
Harold knew that the higher up he went, the farther he could see. So he decided to make a hill into a mountain.
Oh, wow, he's gonna climb up a mountain? So cool.
So, boop, 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 boop. He went high enough, he thought he could see the window of his bedroom.
Oh, he's looking for his bedroom.
He was tired, and he felt he ought to be getting to bed.
I'm tired. I'm getting sleepy.
He hoped he could see his bedroom window from the top of the mountain.
He's all the way to the top of the mountain. Oh, no!
As he looked down over the other side, he slipped. Oh, I'm falling. Oh, no. But there wasn't any other side of the mountain. He didn't draw the other side of the mountain. Hurry, Harold, draw the other side of the mountain. Hurry, Harold. But luckily, he kept his wits and his purple crayon. So what did he draw? A parachute? A balloon? He made a balloon and he grabbed into it. That's a strong balloon. I'll make a. And he made a basket under the balloon big enough to stand in. Oh, that's so smart. I was just thinking about a balloon basket. He had a fine grin for the balloon, but he couldn't see his window. He couldn't even see a house. Oh, he's lost. We gotta help him find his home. So he made a house with windows. Oh, wow, that's a really cool house. It's two-story with lots of windows. He landed the balloon on the grass in the front yard. None of the windows was his windows. Oh, no, it's not his house. Not his bedroom window. He tried to think where his window ought to be. Where should my window be? So he made some more windows. He's making so many windows. That's cool. He made a big building full of windows. Wow, he drew a big building. He made lots of buildings full of windows. That looks like New York City. That's a huge city. Lots of windows. He made a whole city full of windows. Where do you think those cities are? It could be Los Angeles, it could be New York, it could be Australia, China, Tokyo. I don't know. He couldn't think where it might be. It's a city. I know it's a city. He decided to ask a policeman. So he's drawing a policeman. Two eyes, nose, ears, mouth. The policeman pointed the way Harold was going anyway, but Harold thanked him. Thank you, Mr. Policeman, for guiding my way back home. And he walked along the moon, wishing he was in his room and in bed. Yeah, because he had a huge adventure. Now it's time to go to sleep. Then suddenly, Harold remembered. He remembered where his bedroom window was when there was a moon. The moon is his buddy. His moon helps him. It was always right around the moon. Aww. And then Harold made his window and the moon in his bed. Oh, he's got the coolest bed ever. It's so cozy. Nice, comfortable blankets and a soft pillow. So he made his bed. The purple crayon dropped on the floor and Harold fell fast asleep. Snug in his bed, safe in his home, in his house. The end. Brought to you by Sir Herbert Sneaky's pals, Lady Twizzleton. Check out some of her sneaky books. Jack the Bear and Golden Hair at Amazon.